Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello guys, I'm Sir Shakirin from Perak Matriculation College. This is a second video for the third week computer science DC024. Now we are going to look to next subtopic. Okay, in the last subtopic we have discussed about the sequence problems types. And we have also discussed about the contrastation of sequence. We have looked for the five example in the previous video. And let's move for today's. Let's move for the next types of problem. It's about the selection control structure. In the problem analysis step, we have to try to identify the input, process and the output. And for this selection, looks to this problem statement. Okay, the program will display message A. This double quote show a message A. If mark, okay, if mark enter is greater or equal to 80, the program will display message A if mark greater or equal to 80. Okay, before we proceed to the IPO, let's look to the idea, to the main idea of this problem statement. Okay, the main idea here is first display. Okay, we display message A. And the second idea is if mark greater or equal to 80. First idea and the second idea. Okay, as we know, what is actually input? Input is a data needed to process. And process is a stage where we manipulate the input to show the output. Output is the processed item that have been processed by the process stage. Okay. Alright, what is the answer? What is the IPO? The IPO for the this problem statement. Okay, if you see here, this mark is going to be manipulated. Okay, it's going to be test. So the input for the problem statement here is mark, and this mark are going to be test, and the process is to determine whether the mark enter is more than or equal to 80. It is a condition. The condition to test the mark. And the message or the output here is display message A. Okay? Alright. Look to the next example. Example 7. Problem statement. The program will display message A if mark enter is greater or equal to 80. Okay. Or message B if mark enter is in between 70 to 79. Okay, the idea here, we try to extract the idea. Okay, the idea here, first, display A. We are asked for to display A. And the next idea is if ma greater or equal to 80, and the third idea, b if ma between 70 to 79. Okay, there is three ideas here. Display A if ma greater or equal to 80, or B if ma between 70 to 79. Look to the answer here. The input is still ma, and this input going to be test. Determine whether the ma enter is more than equal to 80, because we are going to display if more than equal to 80, it will display A, or between 70 to 79, it will display B. This part between 70 to 79 is to display B. More than equal to 80 is going to be to display A. Means they have two types of output, message A or message B. Okay, now let's look to the example A. In this example A, the program will display message A if ma enter is greater or equal to 80. Or, okay, message B, if ma enter is in between 70 to 79. Or message C, if ma enter is less than 70. Okay, right, we have how many parts here? Display A if ma enter equal to 80, B if ma enter between 70 to 79, or C if ma enter is less than 70. We have three statements here. We have three. Okay. We have this one is first part. This one is second part, and the C is third part. We have three ideas here, and the idea can be shown here. It's still the same. Input is ma. Determine whether the ma enter is more than equal to 80 for displaying A, or between 70 to 79 to display B, or less than 70 to display message C. To display message A, to display message B here, and the less than 70 to display message C. They have three types of output here: message A, message B, and message C. Okay, now look to the example number 9. Okay, for the example number 9, it's quite different from the example 6, 7, and 8. The program will find average of two tests. Okay, then the program will display status pass if average ma greater than or equal to 80, or okay, in the selection, the tips for the selection types problem is look to the word for. Look to the words or here. Okay, find average of two tests. This page test expires if average mean is greater or equal to 80, or display message fail if average mean is less than 80. They have three parts here. Find average, display pass if average greater or equal to 80, or display fail if average mean is 3 is less than. There's three idea here. Three ideas here. Okay, what is the answer? Input, process, and output. Okay, for this problem statement, the input is test 1 and test 2. Because this test 1 and test 2 are going to be used for to calculate the average mark. And the process here is, they have two way of answer that you can use. The first is determine whether the average mark is more than 79. Why is only more than 79? Because if more than 79, it meet the second part here. The will display status part if average mark is greater than or equal to 80 mean is more than 79, and it will display pass. Either then, sorry, else means else of this value of average mark is will display message fail. Means everything average mark is less than 80, because we look to the question, fail if average mark less than 80 means less than 80 is less than it start from the value 79 to the 0, is will be fail. Okay, the other way to write this answer is by using this way. The way to show that it, we can just change the part here to the mark is more than or equal to 80. Okay, this both you can use either this one or this one to show the process of the problem step. Okay, class, I think that's all for today for this video. Okay, we're going to meet in the other series of video. Okay, see you again. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye-bye.